Bienvenue à Edison. For the past 2 months now, we have poured our blood, sweat, and tears into this play, and we're very excited to show you what we came up with.
This play is not a representation or support of any recent presidential candidates. It is not meant to be viewed as such.
Our goal for this play is not only to entertain, but to show the effect the election had on Edison students.
Because we want to show you what we as high schoolers see and feel.
Guten Abend, meine Damen und Herren, y bienvenidos a todos ustedes esta noche. Tonight, you will hear our full story.
Thanks for being here. So, Adubada, Mulia, and Mulway. Tonight, we'll be sharing something amazing.
These voices are not just from the cast. We have collected every letter, note, and image from all corners of Edison. This production is a representation of all of us.
Jonzo, again, we derive motivation from our very young students express emotion.
Our goal is not to force our opinions upon you or to perform a Saturday Night Live type show for you tonight.
Your opinions are valid, but we hope you keep an open mind while watching.
Our goal for this play is to have people come to this play with a different perspective, wanting to make a change.
I didn't think we would ever get a finished product. Writing is hard. Writing with a group of people, it's even harder. It's about taking a little bit of everyone's idea to create one work of art.
When we first began, we were nothing but a humble gathering of hopeful people. People looking to make their voices heard. And now, our voices are stronger and louder, and we are braver and prouder than ever.
If nothing else, we hope you leave tonight entertained and with a greater understanding of our common humanity.
As you sit here this evening, we ask you to think of your own stories and try to understand ours. Each person has a different story, a story that should be known. And these stories are going to make a difference.
Out of respect to the actors and other audience members, we ask that you please turn off your cell phones and refrain from flash photography. We'll get it done.
So sit back and enjoy Thomas Edison High School Theater's production of Dear Mr. President, sponsored by the Eastside Youth Co-op.
Good morning, class. Now, I know you've probably talked about this in your other classes, but I just wanted to say that we're in this together, even with the new president.
Please do not start this.
What was that?
I wasn't going to come to school today just to avoid this conversation, but here I am and here it is.
Well, do you feel comfortable talking about the subject?
Who would? Especially if you're part of that ethnicity that our president is discriminating against. I mean, but don't you think there must be a reason that people voted for him?
But why should they think with their reasons for? They had his speeches. They stood in proud, cheering him on while he perpetuated lies. They support and continue to defend his hypocritical actions, so why should they think with their reasons for?
Exactly. You can't make America great again if it was never great to begin with.
It's already bad enough that I'm being judged behind my back.
My family immigrated here with a passion for freedom. When I started school here and made a home here in America, I felt more loved, respected, and welcome than I did in my own country.
I was born here in the United States. I'm not an immigrant from Africa. Yes, I am an African-American, but he makes it hard to be seen as anything more than a dark-skinned face with a bad background.
So now that a rich white man in power is judging my culture from my face because I wear a hijab, a piece of fabric, am I a mannequin?
Now that he's president of this free land, I'm afraid I won't be able to call this place home.
It's already hard enough to walk through a grocery store without being accused of stealing. I don't rob people, and I'm not any part of the game.
I mean, he spends since it gives people the permission to misjudge my life and my culture, to label me as a stereotype deemed unworthy of respect.
What if I'm not a racist or a criminal? What if I am documented? Those supporting him would really be surprised if they just
come yet.
I didn't think you would get this deep, but you don't understand because it doesn't affect you or Miss Eleanor.
You might be having your own personal family struggles, but just because your skin pigment is lighter, you automatically have to deal with that.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to offend anyone. I was just trying to keep an open mind.
Okay, now listen, class.
No! I'm tired of saying chill or calm!
Our voices need to be heard.
We are more than different.
We have parents who work harder than ever to provide for our families.
We are young minds who want to be able to see their futures as bright as they can be.
We're just trying to do the right thing.
We are the future, and we are tired of being in the background.
He left his homeland in 1904,
leaving his wife, Helena, and his three daughters, Stefana, Antoinette, and Anna. Money was scarce, but tickets to America were scarcer. He knew that he would have to go alone. There was no internet in those days. No texting, no email, just letters, scrawled on a loose sheet of paper and then shipped across the Atlantic. I often wonder what he would say in those letters, whether he would express gratitude for finding a job in the mill, or anguish over the way he was treated. He was insulted, discriminated against, and was the target of cruel derogatives that still survive to this day. The unofficial nickname of our section of Minneapolis, Nordeast, for example, was originally created to ridicule Polish men who, like my grandfather, could not pronounce their THs due to their accents. Despite all this, my grandfather persevered. He woke up alone every morning for 5 years and walked to the Pillsbury A Mill, which is now an apartment that hundreds of people call home. Never in his lifetime did he imagine that his place of work would become a hip apartment in an up-and-coming part of the city. Despite all this, my grandfather continued to work and even took odd jobs to supplement his meager income. He sent nearly all of the money home back to Poland with his wife and children. There was finally enough money for them to join him in America in 1909. They first moved to 12th Street. Their first son, Josef, was born there in 1911. My grandfather was so proud of his first boy that he went down to Central and bought a cradle at a pawn shop. My brother and I used that cradle. They moved again in 1912. This time to Main Street. This is where Stefan was born. They had four more children after they moved yet again in 1914. My great-grandfather was born in 1911. My family's had a good run in Northeast so far. We've had our challenges, just as any family has, but for the most part, Northeast has been good to us. And it'll always be home.
About the local church bells, about toilets, the local spa with the best French fries. Northeast is interconnected through our history, through our immigrants, and the way families look out for each other. Anna said that the strong, diverse community of Northeast is why she's still here today.
I cannot imagine Northeast ever being different than it is today. Everyone's different experiences have made the Northeast that I've grown up in and learned to love. But I guess that's what it's about, right?
Keep going, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to believe in a system where people are safe, trust each other, and don't have to be fearful of the future. The answer to who I am a woman. I am a student. I am a daughter. I am a friend. I am someone who experiences matter, who not only cares about my future, but everyone. I would not live in my 10 minutes of fear. I will fight on.
Sacrifices people make for the love of their country.
President Trump
you know that Bernie Sanders had an affair with Katy Perry?
That's not new.
Mom, it's on Twitter. It'll be in the news tomorrow.
Oh, I can't deal with this today.
Back in my day, we read the newspaper.
Back in my day, we lived in caves and hunted dinosaurs.
Come on, let's read more news.
Yeah.
Start today with all this damn pain. Yeah, I'm equal, we're equal, we are. This is my story. Hey, oh, oh, yeah, this is my story. Hey, you're equal, I'm equal, we are. This is our story.
Respecting your country in the way that you're most proud.
Okay, well let me Are you even celebrating this holiday?
Yes, I am. I might even be celebrating it differently than you are, but that doesn't make me any less of an American. I may not have hot dogs or play the same music, but I'm proud to be an American. And I respect this country just as much as you do.
Okay, well, we can politely disagree. And I wish you a happy 4th of July, whatever that means to you.
Happy 4th of July.
You too.
The U.S. has become a dumping ground for everybody else's problems. And these are the best and the finest. When Mexico sends its people, they're not sending their best. They're not sending you. They're not sending you. They're sending people that have lots of problems, and they're bringing those problems with them.
This is them told, bro.
They're bringing drugs. They're bringing crime.
La letra es mía, pero el criterio y la opinión depende de nosotros. Escribo y describo todo aquello que te niega saber. A ti que me estás escuchando, no seas parte de este abuso de poder. Yeah.
Señor presidente, tú que sabes lo que es ganarse el dinero trabajando duro con el sudor de la frente. Catalogas a todos como matones y delincuentes, sin tener en cuenta que a tu alrededor hay gente decente, como los del Valle de Salinas y todos aquellos indocumentados que tú discriminas, poniendo el miedo con tus amenazas y redadas pasivas. Tienes que las personas que hacen daño son muy pocas. El inmigrante no viene a vender sustancias como la coca, vienen a hacer los trabajos que a los otros no les toca. Debes pensar antes que las palabras salgan de tu boca. De la vida de los demás, ningún mundo imperfecto te atreves a juzgar, a más ni pensar. Tú que sabes todo lo que cada uno ha tenido que pasar, ríos y desiertos debe cruzar, salir de casa con la esperanza de llegar, pero con el miedo de nunca regresar. Hay miles de historias para contar y cientos de familias que no paran de llorar. Buscar comida en otro país no nos convierte en criminales. El tono de la piel y el idioma no nos hace desiguales. Mientras haya pobreza, este seguirá siendo el país de las oportunidades. La gente busca un cambio y el cambio empieza por nosotros. Mirar nuestros defectos y no juzgar a los otros. Bendiciones en sus tumbas a todos los que se quedan en el río, en el desierto y en el trayecto del camino. Solo quedan historias de todo lo que has sufrido. A ti, americano de buen corazón, reflexiona sobre tu voto. No seas causante del dolor de tus corazones rotos. Tú que eres de buen pensamiento, somos de diferentes idiomas, pero sientes lo que yo siento. No somos delincuentes, trabajamos para la familia como toda la gente. Solamente no volver a casa. Mi raza no es una amenaza. No somos delincuentes. Esta es mi opinión. Muchos vienen a este país con una misión: salir de la pobreza y a sus hijos pagarles una buena educación. A más de uno le duele ver en este mundo tanta discriminación. Mi raza se inclinará ante la oración. Pongo mi grano de arena. Recuerda que con tu apoyo podemos hacer un cambio en esta nación. Esto es para todo aquel que se siente identificado con esta canción. Solo tú sabes lo que vales. No estamos solos, continuemos el legado de César Chávez. Que hablen mal de nosotros, no hay que dejarles. Yo sé que hay americanos razonables, gente que sabe el trabajo de un inmigrante. ¿Por qué no te tomas la molestia de preguntarles cuáles son los criminales que tú señalas? Ellos sí saben que no hay gente mala. Mi voz es mi única arma y tú eres el causante de que presione el gatillo para que la bala salga. No tomes decisiones equivocadas que pueden tumbar tus ambiciones. La voz del pueblo cesará en condiciones. Este país está conformado por soñadores que cada día luchan para ser tus mejores. Mira a tus alrededores. Hay doctores, músicos, artistas, profesores. Gente que viene a pisar este territorio solo con un propósito: ser mejores cada día. Esas partes de familias separadas, de personas que terminan en la calle sin nada. Esto es mío, y de todo aquel que está cansado del mundo. De toda la persona puede ser perfecta. Recuerda que siempre vence al mal. Solo tú decides terminar.
I still can't believe he won. Exciting night, wasn't it?
Yes, it was very mind-blowing.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How did you sleep last night?
Fine. I feel relieved now.
I feel relieved too, you know. When I got home from work yesterday, I wasn't even going to turn on the election because I didn't think he was going to win, but once I turned on the TV and then he started winning states, so I thought, you know, it would just be wrong to turn the TV off then. So I stayed up till the end, and now I can't believe that he actually won.
Do you think there's going to be any immediate change?
Well, he doesn't get sworn until January, so nothing until then, but at least the people in Washington know that not everyone agrees with them. Not everyone thinks our country is heading in the right direction.
God bless America.
Isn't it great?
It'll be so refreshing not having a Washington insider in the office anymore.
Doesn't have very many friends in Washington, but neither do we.
And neither will I in school anymore.
Why? Why do you say that?
Yeah, some of you have great friends. Well, I posted about it on Facebook last night, and they didn't seem to like it too much.
Well, what did you post?
Just the same stuff you guys have been saying. Like, I'm so happy you won, make America great again. Well, what's wrong with having a political opinion? I think more kids your age should be interested in politics. Nothing, but when your opinion's different than theirs, see, that's the problem. People are too focused on differences. Right now, we need to be united and embrace the president who cares most about this country.
Who would argue with that?
Well, there are some people who are too politically correct to recognize that everybody in America has their own problems right now.
Well, I'm sick of being called a racist. They always stereotype us as racist, sexist, homophobic, fat, but we aren't. Do you think there aren't racist Democrats? So what do I do? Well, we do what we've always done. Respect everyone and be nice, even if they aren't nice to you, because that's the most important thing we can be. Nice. Morning, Dad.
I'm so sorry this country has failed you. Our country just made the most bigoted choice it could.
I can't believe that Cheeto won!
Morning, Dad.
Did you turn the TV on? Well, I'm turning it off. I can't deal with this.
Looks like somebody's happy about the election. Our neighbors voted for him.
What? Rebecca? But she's my best friend. Her family's so nice and he's so mean.
I'm shocked. They've been so nice to you girls. I can't believe they voted for a man who treats women the way he does.
I was just over their house last night and they were so kind.
Well, maybe she's not as good of a friend as you thought.
I don't know if I can ever look them in the face anymore. Especially since they knew how much I hate him.
Dad, do I have to go to school today? I'm scared.
Yes, we have to keep going on with our lives.
But what if people get violent? What if they write things on our lockers? I won't feel safe.
We have to try to be reasonable people. There will be people who are happy about the election results. Remember, it doesn't make them bad people. They probably have their reasons.
So we're supposed to just act normal. But the world isn't normal anymore, especially when our friends aren't who we thought they were.
Remember, they're still the nice people they were yesterday. We have to give them a chance.
A chance? A chance, Dad? They voted for a man who doesn't care about us, and whether or not they agree with what I said, they voted for him, and that matters.
People are more than their politics, Madame. It shouldn't matter in the long run who they voted for. What matters is that they're nice people.
Well, then I don't care if they're nice. Their choices are endangering our lives and they don't even realize it. It matters who they put in power and how they treat people like us. It matters that they put their wants over our needs. They know I don't care if they're
memories. One girl, a doll that I got to get from my gun pack, a mosquito net, fake Kenyan IDs, caustic nostalgics, fear, fear, fear. Only stars I remember are the flakes of fire we built in the middle of nowhere. Only stripes I saw chained us to the damning prison of existence. A week, 2 weeks, a month, we lost touch of calm. We brought with us a cooking pot, biscuits, 5 cans of rice, a photo of patience, patience, patience. We let go of love-infiltrated lives in a matter of hours and threw ourselves at a chance to leave in peace, away from guns and threats. We were running away from cries, from looted houses, from a war that would hunt us. And my mom, visibly scared, hoping that we'd find safety, her beautiful smile haunted by grief, tormented by worry, her charming personality now all gloomy, I blame. We took with us a forgetful memory. Hobeya, hobeya, hobeya. She cried out of hopelessness, but turned right back and soothed us. You see, it was my 2-month-old sister and I. We took with us. Hobeya, hobeya, hobeya. 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 She sang to us when we got too hungry, when our bodies couldn't comprehend what was going on. She sang beautifully, in fear, to God, in dread. We brought with us darkened souls, nightmares, lifelessness. We took with us hope.
Are going to make a difference.
When your opinions are different, people treat you differently.
nothing compared to others.
We have no choice.